Welcome back. I'm your sister teacher, Maya Gurani. So students, today we will discuss a new chapter of social and political science. The name of the chapter is Why Do We Need a Parliament? Let's first discuss the introduction of the chapter.
Introduction to the parliamentary system. In this chapter, we will learn the machinery of the system of government as given in the Indian Constitution. Have you ever thought of this? What is parliamentary system of government? In India, we have Prime Minister, but why is there no Prime Minister in the United States of America? What is the difference between a parliamentary and a presidential system of government? These questions would lead us to conclude that every country has a different form of government. Before we go ahead to understand different types of government system, let us get information about the main branches of the government. The function of the legislature is to make laws. Legislature means the body of assembly. The executive implements the law and the judiciary provides the justice. The function of these organs, their jurisdiction and limitations on their power, and the interrelationship between these organs are decided by the Constitution. It is the nature of their interrelationship that determines the system of government adopted in the particular country. So, there are two types of government system. First is parliamentary system and the second is presidential system. Parliamentary system of government. The parliamentary system of government developed primarily in England. The English constitution is an unwritten constitution. The government is carried out in accordance with traditions and the customs and the conventions. The British Parliament is an institution that has evolved over a period of time. The parliamentary system of government, having its root in Parliament, is considered as a contribution of England. India has developed this parliamentary system. We can see some broad similarities in the parliamentary system of England and the parliamentary system of India. But when we look at an institutional level, the Indian parliamentary system is different in its content.
India has a parliamentary form of government, and the parliament is the pivot, or we can say the center, around which all the political system revolves. So the word parliament has been derived from the French word parler, which means to talk. So we can say that the parliament is a place where the representatives of the people, they sit to discuss, debate or deliberate about the national or international issues. So the parliament, it expresses the spirit of the democracy. As we have discussed in the first chapter of social and political science, the name of the chapter is Constitution, where we discuss the parliamentary form of government, wherein we discuss the legislature, the executive and the judiciary. So here we will take the part of the legislature, which is the important part of the parliament. So it shows the idea of people's participation in decision making. It shows that the as this parliament, where there is the representatives that have been elected by us directly or indirectly, and on behalf of us or on behalf of the people, these people, they are taking the decision in the parliament. So now let's discuss why should people decide. Why there was a need of the people decision in the law making? As we know that we got freedom or we got independence on 15 August 1947 after the Indian National Movement. Thank you. are they inspired by the ideas of freedom, equality and participation in the decision making. Because during the reigns of British government, the people, they are not allowed to participate in the decision making, or they are not allowed to vote. And the people, they are bound to obey or to follow the rules of the British government. And they faced a grave danger when they criticized the decision of the Britishers. And also they had the fear of the severe punishment. The whole situation was changed after the national movement. These nationalists, they began to criticize the British government and ask for their demand. And also in 1885, the Indian National Congress demanded for the elected members in the legislature with the right to discuss about the budget and the ask questions. So there was a pressure to the British government. So with this pressure, they issued an act, the Government of India Act in 1909. So this act, now some of the people, they have given right to vote. But not all. All the alert adults are not included in this act. So after independence, these leaders, they felt for the all the people must vote. So they come universal adult franchises. According to the universal adult franchises, as we have already discussed in the first chapter, that all the citizens of the India, they have equal right to vote, and this is also a political right of each and every citizens of India who are living in a democratic country.
Universal adult franchise. One of the most remarkable features of Indian democracy is that from the very beginning, that Constitution of India gave the citizens of the country universal adult franchise. This has enabled all the citizens of voting age to irrespective of the caste, religion, wealth or sex. In many other democratic countries including UK and the USA, some sections of the population such as the poor and the women have got voting rights after long period of their struggle.
Just we have discussed that how our Indians, they were struggling a lot when they were getting the freedom. As some of the people, they were not coming forward. The reason was, as the people who resist the law and regulation imposed by the Britishers, they would get a severe punishment. But after the Indian National Movement, the people started, these nationalists started criticizing the British government and asked for their demand. What were their demand? The first demand was, as they wanted the equal right to vote, and the second, they want the elected members in the parliament among the Indians. After all consequences, our framers, they felt that, and also they guarantee to the people the right to vote as they adopted the universal adult franchises. Moving ahead to the point, the people and their representatives. So students, as we know that best form of government is a democracy. In 20th century, it is because, see, many of the countries, or we can say the 50% of the country, they have adopted the democracy or turned to democracy as they were non-democratic country. So we can say ultimately that the best form of government is a democracy. And as it is said by the Abraham Lincoln, that democracy is of the people, by the people, and for the people. Of the people means democracy, it serves of the people, and the elected representatives are by the people, and it serves for the people. So ultimately, the democracy that revolves around the people, and it is all dependent on the consent and participation of the people. This consent and the participation is first and foremost requirement of fulfilling of any of the government. So what is this consent? The consent is based on the desire, approval, and third is desire, approval, and the third is participation. So if the people, they need any of the rule or any of the law should be placed, so this is the desire of the people. And they when they ask for the approval, when it is approved by the parliament, or we can say the elected members, so it is called the approval. And when there is a participation of the people, directly or indirectly, when they were approving or when they were desiring any of the law, so the people participation makes this consent. So every individual's consent is required to run a successful government, or we can say the democracy. So the consent, it is based on three things: the desire, approval, or the participation. What is desire here? A large section of the people, when they decide and when they need any of the system or the law, so this is their desire. And they, when they ask for the approval for the member of the parliament, so they ask, and when it is approved, so it is the approval. And when the people, they participate in this, how they participate? When there is the desire or any of the system is approved, so they participate in this by participating in the election. So we can say that the people play a very important role in the democracy. Without the people, any government cannot run their function successfully. And if they need to run their government successfully, or you need a support of the people to run a strong government so that you can execute or frame the law easily. Or without the support of the people, you cannot be there even for a one day. If the ruling party who loses their confidence in the people house, so the right way they have to resign from their post. So now we will discuss, as we have discussed, the consent that is very important in a democracy. Now we will discuss how the approval of the government is done by the people.
How does the individual give approval to the government? There is one way of doing so: through elections. People would elect their representatives to the parliament. Then one group from among these elected representatives forms the government. The parliament, which is made up of all the representatives together, controls and guides the government. In this sense, people, through their chosen representatives, form the government and also control it.